Last weekend, Bill, Andy, and I ventured to the Conservative Political Action Conference in Washington, D.C., where we spoke to a sold-out auditorium full of hot-looking college students and frumpy journalists. It was there that we met a lot of amazing Red Eye fans, truly amazing, talked with some inspiring young leaders, and drank ourselves into a mindless, sweaty lump of shivering madness. And we all came back with stories to tell and videos to show. Also, some really weird and mysterious bruises.
Lincoln.
Check it out.
Why do you think young people are so
predominantly liberal? When you're young, you're driven by a need to impress, a need for attention, and you tend to romanticize things, and by the very nature of being a liberal, you tend to be more romantic. Homelessness, I mean, who wouldn't be for helping a guy down in his luck?
As you get older, you realize you don't know everything, and once you realize that, you think, well, if I don't know everything, people in Washington probably don't know everything, so they probably shouldn't be running everyone's life. And you become a conservative, or if you're smart, a libertarian.
I have a problem with right-wing activists and left-wing activists because they take themselves so seriously.
Well, and when you did that on Arianna Huffington's blog, she liked that. I mean,
yeah.
she actually, not to steal your thunder, she called Greg an ombudsman. Like, she's like, oh, Greg is our ombudsman. we got to really talk to the left, but Greg's got to live as a broad.
Andy, how are your cats?
Bill. I'll handle this one for Andy. Andy does not speak about his cats. I represent both his cats.
You're on at like 3 in the morning. You would be great for college students. Come to our campus. Unfortunately, I am not allowed to go anywhere near.
On the other hand, I have a lot of business cards, so afterwards, let me know.
Yes. Andy loves going to college campuses, often dressed as a woman. What's the difference between proper and improper spending? How about Andy hand that? Improper strippers.
Proper before 11 p.m., after 11 p.m., improper.
Proper stuff that you can't do on your own. You know, I have tried to form a standing army, but I can't. What is the most challenging idea affecting the conservative movement? I think it always goes back to the general stereotype that was out of your control for ages, which is that you guys aren't fun.
I would say the other big challenge facing conservatives is if you're married, you don't go on Craigslist and sex.
If you had to marry a liberal, who would it be?
I can't say I'm married. I can't answer that question.
Yes, he's here. Yeah, he's married.
Where do babies come from besides unicorns? I don't think I have to answer that.
Babies are mythological creatures.
Yes.
From Megan McCain, how come nobody invited me?
What Obama policy is the biggest joke and why? The biggest joke for me is that he pretends not to smoke.
something government interfering in the economy.
I have a question.
Sure.
Have you noticed how hot the girls are at CPAC this year?
Wallpaper. Third of all, you're just jealous.
He can dress his
pseudo-scientific mumbo-jumbo he wants. The reason he follows Justin Bieber on Twitter is he's hoping he'll notice him.
My question, where are you guys partying tonight?
Where aren't we?
I can talk. This is the fault of the Red Eye boys. It took me to some kid bar last night.
Bring that up.
No, you're joking.
No, I'm not kidding. America, I don't know why you hate America. Oh, what is this? You want to make out? Lovely time. Oh, look, Andy's joined us.
Oh, hey.
I'm on a three shot.
Yeah.
It's a TV term.
Yeah, but among other things. Andy, what was your fondest memory?
My fondest memory was just, I had no idea I sounded that muffled.
Yeah.
I really have to work on my diction, apparently.
Yes, you sounded terrible. It was an embarrassment for everybody.
I remember none of it. So it looked like we had a good time. I think it looked like we did okay, assuming that was really us.
Yeah.
And that's all I know.
I have an interesting question for Essie. You were there, weren't you?
I was.
Yeah. Didn't you have a panel you were supposed to do Saturday?
What happened there?
Yeah, what happened?
Well, I went out with you guys. I actually had Ann's disease. Literally could not talk in the morning.
You had what disease?
And I could not talk. I was actually the first to leave y'all, of all of you. I was the first to leave that night to go home to my hotel room, knowing I had a panel the next morning, but I couldn't talk.
Well, and also knowing that you were already rip-roaring drunk from starting to drink at noon that day.
I had a show that day.
Essie, didn't you also steal a bottle of champagne?
Yes.
You gave me a bottle of champagne to hold for you and then never came back to claim it.
First of all,
after she ran away.
Yeah,
drinking and holding is not the same thing.
Sounds like theft to me.
I was responsible, and I was punished for it in the morning.
How much did you drink, really?
You know, commensurate with my body size.
last question to Bill. I noticed that you stayed an extra day through the tweets I saw in which you were seen entering